What's darker than a moonless night? What's deeper than the Mariana Trench? The answer to both is the dark net. Did you know that the World Wide Web we all use every day makes up just 4% of the internet? The remaining 96%, the dark net, is what we'll dive into today. Welcome to our deep dive, exploring the dark net, cybersecurity, and... The term dark web often evokes cinematic images of mysterious cyber rogues prowling in search of forbidden goods, private data, or the latest cyber attack tools. But here's a twist. It was actually the US government that birthed this enigmatic part of the internet to transmit classified information. Now, let's dive a bit deeper. The internet is like an iceberg. What you see is just a fraction of what's actually there. The deep web represents the submerged part of this iceberg. Search engines like Google can't reach this part of the internet. Websites with the quote-unquote .onion suffix, for example, can only be accessed anonymously if you know the full address. The dark web is even more clandestine. It's a smaller segment of the deep web, a place where websites are encrypted or require special software to enter. It's sort of like the secret back room of the internet, where the door only opens if you know the special knock. Cyber rogues sometimes gather in these digital back rooms, sharing illicit knowledge and shielding their activities from accidental discovery by search engine explorers. Anyone who has climbed the educational ladder to achieve a master's degree in cybersecurity online will tell you that the dark web is like a bazaar, teeming with hacking tools and insights. It's an unexpected goldmine for professional penetration testers, security analysts, and software developers looking to deepen their understanding of cybersecurity. In the secret corridors of the dark web, they can learn a lot by studying the digital discussions on hacking forums. All right, let's dive into a bit of a history lesson on the dark web and see if we can shed some light on its shadowy nature. Here's a surprising twist. The dark web was actually a government invention designed to anonymize intelligence communications. Using specialized hardware and software, it essentially reroutes data traffic to keep information hidden. Want to tiptoe into this clandestine corner of the internet? You'll need to equip yourself with something like the Tor browser or the Invisible Internet Protocol, I2P. It's kind of like donning a digital invisibility cloak. In an article titled Understanding the Dark Net and Its Impact on Cybersecurity, published in Security Boulevard, Radware says that Tor, T-O-R, which stands for Onion Router or Onion Routing, is primarily designed to keep users off the radar. Quite aptly named, if you ask me. Here's why. Picture an onion with its multiple layers. Data on the Tor network is similarly encrypted on multiple levels, each one peeling back to reveal the one behind it as the data passes through. It's kind of like a digital pass the parcel. This two-way data travel through the same tunnel or conduit ensures a smooth journey for the information. And would you believe that every day over a million people stroll down these shadowy digital lanes of the Tor network? That's quite the bustling crowd for a place that's supposed to be dark, don't you think? Are you enjoying the video? I want to remind you to subscribe to our channel for more exciting and informative videos. Exploring Digital Highways, a journey through ClearNet and the covert channels of the dark net. All right, let's imagine the internet as a massive highway system. When you, sitting comfortably at home, punch in a website address like google.com.au into your browser, it's like sending out your car on a journey. Your home router is like your home garage, the starting point. Your internet service provider, ISP, will then allow your digital vehicle to travel on the highway. It travels from one checkpoint to another, or in tech lingo, from router to router. This continues until your digital car reaches its destination, the server hosting your desired website, in this case, the Google Australia homepage. Using digital GPS tools like Traceroute, you can see the exact route your data card took from your home PC to the web server. The journey may have some minor detours over time due to the network's routing rules, but it'll most likely stick to the same path. However, because this ride isn't in a bulletproof tinted vehicle, anyone can peek in, intercept, or even tamper with your data because it isn't encrypted. That is the ClearNet. Now let's flip over to the covert side of the road, the Tor Darknet. Here, the journey your data takes is a bit more like James Bond's. When you visit a web page, your computer sends your data first to the Tor routing software. Think of it as a secret tunnel entrance. This software then escorts your data through encrypted tunnels to one or more of the roughly 3,500 Tor entrance relays, a secret network of hidden checkpoints. From the entrance relay, your data continues to sneak through multiple encrypted tunnels, bouncing off different Tor relays. Finally, your data emerges from the last of these secret relays, known as the Tor exit nodes, and steps back into the ClearNet highway to reach the server. But unlike ClearNet travel, your data's entry into or exit from the Tor network isn't visible. All that can be seen is the ClearNet path taken by the data. It's like your data car encountered a magical cloak and reappeared near its destination, its journey largely untraceable. In the clandestine world of the Darknet, users have an alternative to using a proxy to connect with ClearNet services. They can utilize what's aptly called hidden services to access websites and applications. Picture these as hidden doors that only open if you're traveling on the Darknet's encrypted paths. For the ClearNet user, these doors remain mysteriously locked. These hidden services are masters of disguise, keeping both the application's host and user shrouded in anonymity. Sure, it offers a range of legitimate perks. Think of heightened security and privacy. But as with all things, there's a flip side. This shield of anonymity can become a protective umbrella for illicit services and activities. Activities that could never survive under the bright lights of the ClearNet suddenly find themselves flourishing in the obscure corners of the Darknet, becoming unnervingly difficult to shut down. And that's the thrilling comparison between a straightforward ClearNet journey and the cloak and dagger adventure of the Darknet. Okay, let's break it down and paint a picture of this intriguing digital realm called the Darknet. But first, let's clear the air. Words like dark internet, dark address space, deep web, deep net, dark web, invisible web, undernet, and hidden web are often tossed around interchangeably, but they aren't quite the same as Darknet. Each term has its own unique industry definition. So here, we'll focus on understanding the Darknet and how it compares to its transparent cousin, the ClearNet. First up, encryption. Imagine you're whispering a secret to your friend in a crowded room. That's how ClearNet works. It only encrypts sensitive data, like when you're logging into your bank account. It keeps your secret safe, but it requires more effort and cost from the recipient. But Darknet? It's like everyone in that crowded room is whispering all the time. Every bit of data is encrypted. It's an unbreakable code. Even the mighty National Security Agency, NSA, struggles to decrypt it. And everybody using the Darknet pitches in to bear the extra effort of maintaining this encrypted chatter. Next, anonymity. On ClearNet, your digital footprints are tracked every time you visit a website. Your IP address, your computer details, even the web pages you visited are all logged. It's a bit like a digital detective being able to trace your every step. The Darknet, though, prioritizes anonymity. It's like walking on a beach and having the waves erase your footprints behind you. Unless someone has your digital key or routing map, they can't trace your journey. Plus, any identifiable information you send is usually masked. Then there's routing. ClearNet data travels based on multiple factors like cost, congestion, geography, and others, much like a mail package being delivered. It chooses the most effective route possible. Darknet, on the other hand, is more like an extreme game of hide and seek. The path of data changes frequently and randomly to ensure no one can trace the data's origin or destination. When it comes to applications, ClearNet works with a wide range of software, like your email client, browser, games, and more. Darknet, however, needs specialized software to access it and communicate through it. It's like having a unique key to a secret club. And finally, visibility on ClearNet. Your online activities can be monitored, like someone peeping over your shoulder. The Darknet, in contrast, is far more discreet. Unless someone actively searches for specific suspicious indicators, your connection to the Darknet can often go unnoticed. Cracking the Code, a cybersecurity professional's guide to the dark web. As cybersecurity professionals, it's vital to understand the dark corners of the internet, often known as the dark web. This intricate labyrinth houses a multitude of insights that can help shield our critical systems from online threats. Envision this as a goldmine for strengthening cybersecurity. We delve into these less traveled parts of the internet to fetch valuable information to safeguard our cyberspace. This process, called dark web cyber threat intelligence, can be a game changer in identifying and neutralizing cyber threats. For instance, in Jasmine Henry's enlightening piece, Seven Ways to Identify Darknet Cybersecurity Risks, published by Security Intelligence, she brilliantly outlines how to spot and neutralize potential dangers emerging from the shadows of the web. The dark web can indeed be a rich vein of information on cyber threats. Imagine experienced cybersecurity sleuths immersing themselves in the hackers' underworld, learning their tactics and turning the tables on them. Imagine AI algorithms working tirelessly, sifting through onion sites to collect data nuggets. Anyone embarking on a journey in cybersecurity today enters an industry where learning never stops. Cyber criminals might be quick and innovative, always coming up with new tricks, but by studying their tactics via the dark web, we cybersecurity pros can stay one step ahead, learning to dodge their curveballs and protect our cyber world. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more.